morning. So, I'm Michael Las. I'm the CEO of Bang Bang Bangus, and it's my pleasure to be here. I share to you my entrepreneurial journey, and thank you so much, Asia CEO, for this opportunity. Well, to be honest, having a business was not originally on my mind when I was growing up. My dream then was to be a world-class director of films and TV shows. So I studied and graduated with communication arts in Letran. After graduating, I took some video editing short courses, bought a computer, then I accepted video editing jobs for student projects. Well, this is how my first office looked like. It was a part of our home, which used to be a sari-sari store in Paco, Manila. College students would line up on those branches that I placed in the eskinita, waiting to their turn per hour po ang rate ni Kuya Mike eh. Okay? So, this was the start of my creative company. 88ville Communications. And while I was running 88ville, I also accepted directorial jobs in some of the top networks here in the country and abroad. 88ville Communications would later on service some of the top corporations in the Philippines for their events, videos, and trade shows needs. Since entrepreneurship was already activated within me, to diversify my ventures, I also tried franchising a food cart. It was a fun venture. However, there were some harsh learning that I encountered along the way, such as the surprise demolition of a commercial space where our second store was located. I already gave 6 months worth of rent to the lessor, and the demolition happened 2 days after we started operating. And the lessor did not give back the deposit. Even with this setback, running a food cart franchise and having one of the top franchisors as a regular client in 88ville became very important dots, which would help paint the big picture that is Bang Bang Bangus. God blessed me with the business idea during my son's second birthday. While we're eating fried bangus in a Filipino restaurant, this was January 8, 2020, just a few weeks before the first lockdown, the idea was strengthened when we went out to buy takeout dinner and we couldn't find anything aside from roasted chicken and pork. I couldn't stop thinking about it and experimenting on a recipe. My wife, who is creative head of our business, started creating the look, logo, and branding, and she also started the construction of the first Bang Bang store. And while we were set to open on March 27, 2020, the lockdown happened, and all of our 88ville projects were canceled. And we only had our food business as a source of income for the family. What was once side business now demanded our full attention. But you know what's amazing about it? This delay allowed me to improve the recipe, creative the distinct Bang Bang taste that would later on captivate Filipino nationwide. There's so many stories of miracles that happened during the time of wait. And on June 7, 2020, we're on the quarantine, was relaxed to MECQ. We opened the first Bang Bang store in Project 7, Quezon City. The Bang Bang journey began. We became the first flavored fried bangus takeout kiosk in the country. But I tell you, it was not an easy road. Both my wife and I came from the middle class families, and we didn't have much savings, so there wasn't much financial fuel in the business. There were times when I manned the store and cooked. We also delivered the bangus during peak hours because our riders were not enough. We also made our videos and collateral since it had been our business from the past years. The environment, the pandemic environment was difficult. But again, you know what's amazing about it? Since many choose to slow down during the pandemic, I decided to grab the opportunity to speed up. And since we didn't have the funds to expand, I opened the business for franchising. And many joined us and opened up stores in their localities. Some media outlets learned about our offerings and featured us in their shows and pages. In 2021, I joined the Next Gen in Franchising competition of the Philippine Franchise Association. Here, I battled with more than 40 entrepreneurs from all over the country to claim the title of the next big thing in franchising. By God's grace, I was declared as Grand Champion. Thank you. Today, I am one of the committee members of the competition. After the win, more people become interested in franchising Bang Bang. And on October 2021, we decided to step out of Luzon and open Bang Bang franchising to Visayas, then to Mindanao. Today, we have opened more than 100 Bang Bang Bangus stores nationwide. We used to design and make trade show booths for our client last year, but for the first time, we built our own. Also, last year, another big blessing happened. We tried joining the Asia CEO Award Entrepreneur of the Year category, a contest which was beyond our wildest dream. During our 88 Ville days, whenever we passed by an Asia CEO billboard, I would jokingly ask my wife to nominate me in the competition. And last year, she finally did. Amazingly, I was declared as grand winner of the Asia CEO Award Entrepreneur of the Year. And later on, magazine would have me on their cover. Grabe, di ba? Who would thought that someone like me would one day be on this stage? Who would thought that someone who was not a chef, but loved to eat, by the way, who'd be creating recipes that would delight Filipinos from all over the country. Even I never imagined this. All my weakness were used by God to magnify His power. And to all entrepreneurs here, what I'd like to say is that arm yourself with prayers before everything else. Then march on with confidence and diligence as you do your business. Work hard, pray harder, and know that everything that happened to you is part of the journey. We were able to market Bang Bang using our creative skills that we got from our previous jobs and business. We have our share of mistakes. But mistakes become worth it if we learn from it. Also, as much as we can, we also attend seminars because knowledge is always additional fuel. And the victories, no matter how big or small, are to be celebrated and thanked for. Let's press on, fellow entrepreneurs. And while we're at it, let's have that smile in our hearts and know that we have purpose greater than own comfort and survival. And that is to provide jobs to our fellow men so then can provide for their family as well. Thank you so much again, Asia CEO, for the chance to tell my story. Good morning, everyone.